Is like a drunkard, and we behave like a drunkard, everything appears to be chaotic. So people experience the cosmos as chaos because we are drunk. But the moment that drunkenness, the ignorance is dispelled, right, and the same world becomes a different experience. And hence the Veda says, Anandhat eva kalvimani bhutani jayante yena jatani jivanti. Everything is ananda, ananda for a wise person, for an otherwise person. Now everything is misery, misery, misery alone. All that is because one is not wise, one is unwise. And therefore Gayatri Mantra says, Prachodayat, please enlighten my intellect. The moment I am enlightened, I become centered. The moment I become centered, the whole world becomes different. For an enlightened person, everything is an experience. And therefore in the Bhagavad it is said, Sukha is the prasada of the Lord. Dukkha is the Mahaprasada of the Lord. Happiness is the gift of the Lord. Dukkha is the Mahaprasada. Why Mahaprasada? Great gift of the Lord. Because the moment you are enlightened, every experience in life has a message, has something to convey. So an enlightened person, every even a failure he learns, success he learns, everything he learns, learns, learns. It is this wisdom that we have to awaken, and hence, Diyo yo nah prachodayat. Our intellect, please prachodayat. Not only I have to be enlightened, everybody have to be enlightened. Like in management, we say win-win approach. Not only I win, but let the other person also win. Let both win there. Lord Krishna says, parasparam bhavayantaha, mutually nourishing each other. We have to be benefited. Mutually we should nourish. And therefore, diyo yo nah prachodayat. You are asking for the ultimate enlightenment. And therefore, finally to sum up, the Gayatri Mantra is great because of the mantra, the vibration it creates, and because it is asking for enlightenment, which is going to ultimately make a difference to one's life. And therefore, how does it ask? Om stands for silence, peace, bliss. Where does it exist? Bhuhu, Bhuvaha, Suvaha, in the waking dream and deep sleep. Means inside your life only, happiness and silence exist. So don't look out for silence elsewhere, look within. And when you look within, what do you find? Savituhu, there is a sun within. There's a sun within, that's Savituhu. And that Savituhu, that sun, how is it? It is divine. Devasya. Divine to whom? For divine to those people who meditate. Dimahi. People who don't meditate can never experience themselves as divine. Dimahi. We meditate on the divine sun, which is Bhargaha Varenyam, which is the race is effulgent and brilliant, it is there. So when you meditate on who I am, that sun is bright and effulgent. And the moment you see that sun, when well, through the process of seeing, Diyo yo nah prachodayat. Diyo means Diyaha, our intellect. Naha for us, prachodayat. Let it enlighten. The moment I enlightened who I am, such a person, Atma vich shokam tarati, one who knows himself, shokam tarati. This is the meaning of Gayatri Mantra. When you do Savituhu as a nirguna meditation, but if you are doing it as saguna, with a form if you are meditating, then that Savituhu refers to the external sun. Now, when you recognize the external sun, then you are worshipping the sun itself. Now, Gayatri Mantra is not supposed to be chanted in the night. Only if you are chanting this mantra as a worship towards the sun. But if you are chanting this mantra as a worship towards the self, which meaning I have given you right now, then it can be chanted at any point of time. It does not matter any point of time it can be chanted. Right? There is also a big myth that ladies should not chant the mantra. It is not true. Everybody can chant. Tradition was men was chanting because Yajnopavita was not given. The context of that period of time was very, very different. The context of this period of time is very, very different. So ladies also can chant the mantra. It can be chanted any point of time. ultimately the mantra is a, like a wake-up call which is giving you. Always remind yourself, enlightenment is the ultimate purpose of life. Enlightenment is the ultimate purpose, and there you are asking for the ultimate, and therefore Diyo Yo Na Prachodayat. May all of us be enlightened. Just imagine, friends, that if everybody comes from a context, let us be enlightened, let us be enlightened, then you are not operating from an I world, but you are operating from an I and you world. If you look at people, the evil which exists in society is because we are only interested in the I world. And the moment you are interested only in yourself, then please see, everybody is interested in oneself. There is always a clash of egos. But if everybody comes from an intention, let us be enlightened, let us be enlightened, the very intention is an I and you world. When you operate from I and you world, then please see, you don't experience a separate self. You experience what I call it as a unified self. When you experience as a unified self, that unified self is Advaita Bhavana. There is non-duality. Separate self is Dvaita. Advaita is a unified self. And that unified self can happen when you come from an intention of let us be enlightened. So please chant the Gayatri Mantra and remind yourself that let us experience unified self. And may God bless you.
Dhiyo yo na prachodayat.